Hello, in this video, we shall explore common challenges encountered with data flows in Oracle Analytics. This is a follow-up to our previous videos on Oracle Analytics data flows linked in the description. To recap, Oracle Analytics data flows offer lightweight ETL functionality that creates custom datasets by extracting data from supported sources and loading the data after applying required operations. To create a data flow, go to Oracle Analytics and use the Create Data Flow option. Select a source dataset, which can be from any supported connection or file-based source. The data flow's extensive operations allow for combining, transforming, and aggregating data from multiple sources, ultimately producing an output dataset for further modeling and reporting. Each step is validated and data preview is available to assist in constructing the final dataset while minimizing the errors. Do note that the log messages of the execution can be checked by going to the Data Flows History tab and clicking on the status. This will display execution details such as processing time and error information in case of failures. Now let's examine each use case one by one. If a data flow execution fails with an exceeded maximum rows or connection reset message, it implies that the query governance limits based on the compute size of the Oracle Analytics cloud service were not considered. If resizing is not in plan, apply filters or divide the input data sets to stay within the limits and then build the data flow accordingly. Moving on to the next case, if there is a message error executing flow preview within the data flow editor at any step, it typically indicates a mismatch between the columns in the source dataset and those being processed by the data flow. In this example, there is a column hidden in the dataset. To resolve this, ensure that the source dataset in the data flow does not have hidden columns. Deselect the columns or remove the hidden steps during the data preparation step before using in a data flow. Another common issue when running a shared data flow is a data service error, which usually occurs when the data flow has not been executed by its owner before sharing. To avoid this, the data flow owner must run the data flow at least once before sharing the data flow and its related artifacts with other users. Furthermore, ensure that the database of the source or target dataset is active. If the data flow failure log contains ORA messages or service errors, the first step should be to check the database status and connectivity. For instance, the invalid service error, as seen in this case, commonly occurs when the private database connected via remote data gateway is unavailable. The final use case addresses situations where a data flow job or sequence remains in a pending status for an unusually long time, potentially indicating that the job could be stuck due to various issues. It is recommended to first attempt a rerun to ensure success and, if required, cancel the job by navigating to Inspect General tab and select Cancel Job from the Actions menu to clear the pending status. Beyond these common use cases, it is important to review the best practices when using Oracle Analytics data flows to avoid common pitfalls. Additionally, consider using the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Notification and Connector Hub services to receive notification emails in the event of failures to be informed and take immediate action. This concludes our discussion on the common challenges faced in Oracle Analytics data flows and the actions that could be taken to address them. Thanks for watching this video.